everyone, this is Gail. Welcome to my first Tupelo Designs LLC project. I'm going to be doing a card today using some of the great products that I showed in my unboxing yesterday, I believe it was. Today I'm going to be using this die, which is a my favorite things, Dynamics die, and it is a Poinsettia. And as soon as I saw this on their website, I knew I had to have it. So we're going to be using this today. I actually have already done this once, and here's the finished card. And I'll just show you the inside. I always put a white inside in my black cards. But this is the finished card. You can see some of the shimmer and everything on it. The reason I have one already made is because I made a video at my other desk where I do my paperwork, paper carding, I mean, not paper crafting is what I should have said, and went to edit the video, and the video was so far away that you couldn't really see what was going on, and it wouldn't let me zoom while I was doing the video, so I was kind of stuck. So I decided I would just do another one, and I moved everything over to my clay area, and there's better light. I can do close-ups with my camera and everything, but let's get started. Now I'm going to be using a black cardstock, and if you look at this, you'll see that the inside of this cardstock is white. So what I'm going to do is I've got one of these little dewdrop type color box things in black. I'm just going to ink the edges to get rid of that white, because I don't want white showing. You have a nice elegant card and then you have white showing. So just go around all the edges with your black ink, and you might have to do them separately because this one didn't do well. That's got that. And let me do the bottom. So I've inked those, so now no more white core on my black card. Now I'm going to set this aside for a while because I don't need it yet. And I've already done my paper cutting and my die cutting, and because that's what takes so much time, getting my equipment out and doing it. But anyway, this is the Poinsettia die, and I'm going to be using the two pieces. See, what I'm going to use are these two pieces, and this leaf, that leaf, and I'm going to use this center. I originally punched out the two other centers because I didn't know what was going to look the best, but and they're here. Let me put them on the card. These are the centers, but I used this gold sparkly paper, and because it's the gold sparkly paper, you don't see the embossing that's on it, so they just kind of look like scallop circles. If I'd used regular paper, it would have been better. So I decided to use the little inside that has the little circles on it, and that's also in the gold glitter paper. Now the first thing I'm going to do is take my bone folder, and I'm not going to use a scoreboard or anything. I'm just going to take the end and I'm going to score my petals along the embossed stem that is showing. Let me zoom in so you can see that. Can you see that this is embossed here? You can see little lines coming through, and what I'm doing is taking my bone folder and just pressing in where the stem is, the natural stem that's on the embossing. And I'm going to do that on both of them. And they're not straight, so this doesn't have to be straight. And you don't have to be too careful, because all this is going to do is allow me to bend these a little bit so that they look a little more realistic. And I'm going to do the same thing on the leaves. So let me follow that. Okay, that should be the end of that. And all this is going to allow me to do is to bend it a little bit. Now before I go too much further, I've decided to use some stickles. I used them on the other one that I did. Let me go ahead. I'm going to crease these while I talk. I decided to use the stickles after I put these on the card, and it made it a little hard to get the stickles where I wanted it. So I'm going to, after I crease this, because I don't want to touch it once I put the stickles on there, after I crease it, then I will put the stickles on it. A lot of my clay friends have been asking when I mentioned stickles, what stickles is. And stickles is actually a type of a glitter glue. And it's got very, very fine glitter in it. And it's just the glue part dries clear, and it just is just a really nice glue. Now let me find, I had something on the other side. I'll use a piece of my plastic wrap or deli sheet. It's not wrap. But because I'm using a lot of this, I'm going to put some out on my sheet and use my finger. You see just a little bit of green right there, and I'm going to dip my finger in it and just kind of brush the edges a little bit. And then maybe, well, I might go ahead and do the whole thing. I did on the others. Should have known better. I love bling. And you can see this doesn't, well, I'm really close, aren't I? Let me go out just a little bit. Can you see as I turn this, just the little bits of glimmer that's on there? It's very, very fine. Just enough to give it a little bit of bling. And I'll take some more and put it on this one. And you, because the glue gets a little sticky, if it, like you can see, it's all stuck on my finger. You can kind of pat with your finger until some of the stickles, the glitter comes off on your project. But I think that's okay. And I'm going to use a baby wipe to get the glitter off my finger before I start with the other color. Don't want to mix up my green and my red glitter. Although, by the time I finish this, I'm going to have glitter all over me, so it doesn't really matter. I don't know about you. But I'm going to, with these, since they're a little bit larger, I think what I'm going to do is take some stickles and run it down the center. When I keep these in my little container, I keep them upside down, so you'll never have to shake the glitter down to the tip. But see, I can put this on the end, or down the center, not on the end. It's the end of the tube. And then I'll be able to take it and smear it with my finger. Leave that upside down. This is the cranberry stickles that I got in my design team kit. And it looks real pretty on the red. And you just brush it with your fingers. till you get the look that you're looking for. I'd like a little bit more right there. Maybe a little bit less right there. But I love working with stickles. I also use stickles on my polymer clay. So let me get that off my fingers, although I'm going to be using it again. This time I'm going to do the larger poinsettia. You don't have to be too careful about getting it even. But when you put stickles on clay, it's beautiful depending on how you use it. But this is the cranberry stickles that I got in my kit. Tupelo is very generous in providing the products that we need for whatever project we want to do, and I want to thank them for that. They're a wonderful company. I don't know if I've told you, but they also offer rewards where when you sign up, create a new account with them, they give you 500 points automatically, and that's $5 off of your order. You can use it right away as soon as you build up your points, do your create your account first before you do your shopping, and then it all works. And then you earn, there are different ways of earning points. I can just tell that this is going to be all over me. I should have done it a little bit neater, but it's going to be so pretty. Okay, I'm going to let those dry a little bit. The green ones are dry. The green ones are beautiful. See just that little bit of glimmer? So that's going to be nice. I just don't want to get glitter on my black card. So now while we're letting this dry, let's go back to the card. Okay, the card is a regular A2 size card base. And like I said, it is black. And the A2 size is 4 1/4 wide by 5 1/2 inches tall. So what I did is I cut a piece of gold. This is the gold glitter paper that I'm using for the poinsettia. And I cut it just a little bit smaller by about 1/4 inch. I believe this is, the other one was 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. I think I did this 3 1/2 by 4 by 5 1/4, because I didn't go all the way over, because I'm going to stagger. I'm going to double mat and I'm going to stagger them. So this is going to go there. Then I've got a second mat, which is 3 1/2 by 5, and I'm going to line that up down at the bottom of this gold. Actually, I'm going to line this with the edge of the card, and see, I will have a double matted card, and the mat will be staggered. Can you see that? It's going to be staggered a little bit. So I think it's going to be very pretty. So let me get this attached. I am going to use my ATG gun to adhere my mats to my card, and I'm going to run several strips of glue because I want to make sure it's adhered properly. But I'm paying particular attention that it is on the edges, because I don't want the edges to come up. Y'all see the glitter on my work surface. So then you just line this up. With your card, leaving about 1/8 inch all the way around, and press it down. And then do the same thing with the second mat. Use the ATG, and because this is going over the glitter paper, I'm going to really make sure I get a lot of glue on this because this glitter paper is rough and I don't want to use wet glue just because I don't want this to wrinkle up any. So I just make sure I put lots of glue on my card. Love that ATG gun. Now, like I said, I'm going to line this up with the other edge of the card, covering the gold. There. And press it down. Make sure it's stuck to that glitter paper. So there's our mat. Now, I don't know if you can see this. The light's kind of bright. Let me turn this. That doesn't help any. This is a black background with little green, like Christmas tree branches, and little red dots. So I'm going to put that aside. And now I'm going to put my poinsettia together. Now, because the poinsettia, I want it to be dimensional, and I don't want to put, I could put some foam dots on it, on the flower part. Let me do that. I'll be right back. Sorry about that. I thought I had brought everything over. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this over on its back. I'm going to take a little dot and put it on each petal. But I'm going to put it where it won't be seen. These are pretty thick dots, so I hesitated to even use them. But I've got them, so I thought, why not? But I don't think I'm going to put the bottom one on that. I think I'm going to use a glue dot. The glue dot is good and sticky, but it's a little bit smaller. Let me make sure I'm getting this in the right place. Whoops. There, I got the glue dot on it. And I believe I'm going to put this down towards the bottom of the card. Maybe right there. I should have peeled off the paper. But luckily these are flexible, so they will work just the way they are. So I'm pulling the sticky paper off the back of the glue dots. But now that it's got dimension, it'll give support to these poinsettia leaves without having them stuck down. Now with the second one, I don't think I'm going to use dimension on those. I'm just going to make sure that they're pinched. But I think I will use a glue dot. These little dots are on a roll, which is great, but I only want one, so I don't need to run a roll of them. But anyway, I'm going to stagger this poinsettia and turn it so you can see it. Stagger it and so that the small pet leaves are in between the big leaves, and then just stick down that with the glue dot, and then I'm going to take, actually this is a clay tool from my stash, I'm just going to kind of press that in the middle of this to give it some shape. And I believe I'm going to use some wet glue to put this, attach this, and I'm going to use my art glitter glue with my little metal tip. I love that fine metal tip. It comes with a little pin that you can stick in it, and I am going to put some polymer clay on that so I will be able to find it a little bit easier. But then I'm going to stick this center right where I put that wet glue and make sure it's stuck. And there you go. There's the poinsettia. Now with the leaf, I guess I want that to have a little bit of dimension too, but not as much as the poinsettia. So I'm going to use this foam tape. And I don't know if you noticed, I pulled this off of the side. Whenever I cut small pieces, I'll cut something off, like I'll cut a strip for today. And then the rest I stick on the side of my roll. And that allows me to save it for another project, and yet it still keeps it sticky. Now I'll stick that on the side, and these are the two that I'm going to need for my leaf. Let's stick this right about the middle of the leaf, maybe towards the bottom. And the other one is probably stuck to this somewhere. There it is. Kind of in the middle. And peel the sticky paper off. And then you can tuck your leaves wherever you think you need, you would like to have them. I think there's more room. Let's see, I'm going to put a mat up here at the top, so I can put this maybe right here. Just tuck it in there. Well, there's not enough room there. I'm going to have to lift up this little foam dot in order to stick this in. And then I'll stick this. Now they're both stuck. And let me do another one here. I'll lift this foam dot up, press this one down to stick, and then stick the poinsettia on top of that. So now we've got leaves on our poinsettia. Now what I'm going to do with this, and I probably should have done it on my leaves also, I'm going to take a gold stamp pad, and I'm going to use my ink spreader and just ink it up with some gold ink. And I'm going to brush the edges of this. Again, it's got a white core, and you don't want to see the white core, but I really don't want black, so I thought gold would look pretty. Because then it'll kind of give it a little bit of definition when I put it on this dark. I like that. I don't know if you can see it or not. Maybe you'll see it better when I put it on here, but it's going to give it just a little bit of definition. And that's going to look good. Again, I'm going to use my ATG gun. Make sure you get to the edge. Now, I know this is upside down for you, so let me turn it over and make sure I get this centered right where I want it, and then press it down. Now, I don't know if you can see the gold around that green or not, but it looks white, but it's not white. It's gold. Okay. Now, let me cover this up. If you don't have a gold ink pad, this one was in my stash, but if you don't have one, Tupelo also carries the gold stamp pads. So that's nice to know. And I'm also going to use this die cut Merry Christmas. Now, I got a die cut from Tupelo, and I was going to use that. But then one of my dear people that I have met in my paper crafting world, we have a Crafty Lori, who's also a Tupelo design team member. She has a thing on her channel every week, Let the Wishing Begin. And you get to go on there and wish for something that you want. It doesn't have to be craft-wise, but most of them are. And I had wished for some die-cut little bows, because I'm having a hard time finding a Martha Stewart bow cutter that is wonderful, but I'm not paying $25 for it, and that's what it is on Amazon. So she's offered to make me my bows, and my second wish was for a Merry Christmas die cut. Now, at the time, I didn't realize that I was going to be ordering a die cut that says Merry Christmas from Tupelo. But today, I got an envelope thinking it was my bows, and not only did she send the bows, but she also sent me two sizes of these die-cut Merry Christmases. So I told her I would use it on my first card. And here it is. And I'm going to use wet glue because it would be kind of hard to do anything else. And I'm going to try to get it centered. One good thing about wet glue is you can move it around a little bit. There you go. Now, some of the glue, I don't want to get it with my fingers because I'll just get glitter all over everything. Some of the glue comes out, but that's okay. This art glitter glue dries clear. And there you have it. This is my second Merry Christmas card. And it's black with green, and I will do the same thing. I have a sentiment. Let me show you how I do that. On these black cards, it's very difficult to stamp a sentiment on the inside. So if you look at cards that you buy in the store, really nice cards that you'll buy like at Hallmark or whatever, if you look inside their cards, they have a separate piece of paper that has the sentiment on it. And this, so what I did is I went in and I've got really nice, this is not cardstock, it's brochure paper. It's a very nice quality paper. It's much thicker than regular copy paper. And I found some free Christmas sayings on the internet, and so I printed them off. So what I'm, and I've cut them just slightly smaller than the A2 card, and all you have to do, open it up, flip it over, and on the very top of the blank side, just put one strip of your glue, and then you sit it inside your card so that the fold is in the fold, and just let it go up, and that's where it goes. You press that, and now you have a really nice card with this on the inside. So there you go. How do you like that? I hope you like this project, and I hope you'll try Tupelo Designs LLC, and I will put links to all the products I used of theirs in the description box below this video. So please look at it. Please visit them. They're terrific. They really are. Their customer service is great. You usually get a call back if you want a call or an email. They'll answer your email within hours usually, and that's kind of unusual in with these kind of companies. But hope everyone enjoyed this. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you think, and I will see you soon. Thanks. Bye-bye.